Hello and welcome. This is your boy Jack from Steamedworld Presents, and I'm here to present to you my top 10 upcoming movies of 2020. This is my first foray into the top 10 movie or top 10 genre period, so it's a little bit amateurish, I admit. I do intend to actually make more in later date, and I would actually, and in those occasions, I would actually take the time to actually make it, as opposed to trying to do everything within 2 hours. Yes, what you're about to witness is what happens when you rush things and do not plan in advance. So, without further ado, let's check out my top 10 upcoming movies of 2020. Oh, and before I forget, shout out to Storm Chaser, who actually kept asking and persistent in asking me what my upcoming 2020 movies was gonna be. Finally, thank you, I finally did it. Yes, I know, I barely spent time, as I stated earlier, but I did it. And for those of you who haven't actually subscribed to my channel, please take the time now to subscribe to this absolutely fantastic channel. Yes, I know, sound a little bit narcissist, but hey, it's all fun. Alright, so don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to hit the notification button. Let's you know when next I drop a new vid. And don't forget to leave comments down below. Let me know what you think. Let me know what you want me to react to. And if you have nothing to say, just say hey, that's okay. I love reading your comments. I love the interaction. It makes me keep coming back, doing more and more of this. So now, without further ado, here are my top 10 upcoming movie of 2020. Obviously, those that have actually been released prior to this video being dropped has been removed. So, you know, Bad Boys and the rest. So, anyway, let's just go. Now watch, enjoy. Don't be too critical, as I said. It's not really my best work, not even close. Alright, enjoy. Number 10. Bloodshot. This Vin Diesel-led comic book movie seems a little bit off-kilter, just like his characters from the Pitch Black series, you know, Pitch Black, Riddick, Chronicles of Riddick. And so, based on what I've seen so far in the trailer, this might be another vehicle along that line for him, and so far, he seems to do very well with stories that are characters that are actually anti-heroes who fall flat and have to use guts, grits, and whatnot to actually rise above and solve a horrendous situation. Hopefully, this won't be as bad as the third entrance into the XXX franchise. Number 9. Morbius. A chance for Jared Leto to actually prove to the world that the Joker, his portrayal, would have been epic had it been given the chance to shine. Now, DC's loss might be Marvel's Sony gain. This might be the end of his take of the Joker. And also, I guess, he's now part of the Spider-Man universe, so that should be interesting to see how that works out. I'm actually looking forward to it. And the Michael Keaton cameo at the end of the trailer was absolutely brilliant. So hopefully Jared Leto's portrayal of Morbius would shut the critics up and prove that he is a fantastic actor, and that the material he was actually giving with was flawed. Number 8. Top Gun 2. The movie that was probably one of the most effective PSA for the Navy pilot program gets a sequel. I became a huge fan of Tom Cruise as a direct result of the original. It had heart, action, drama, romance, and worked well for what it was. Action-oriented, good-looking cast, living life on the fast lane with pedal to the metal. Most of the original cast are actually coming back for this, and it should be interesting to see them, and also to actually watch Val Kilmer perform after his battle with throat cancer. So this should be fun. It should be a great coda to an awesome series. Number 7. Black Widow. Scarlett Johansson's Black Widow has always been one of the Avengers, along with Hawkeye, that here. I've always wondered how like they came about, and were somehow actually able to hang with the superpowered and mechanized Avengers. Is she in hell? Is she something else? Hopefully, this movie will help reconcile her abilities to step into with the alien menace and her in fighting. Number 6. Birds of Prey. This obvious entry into the DC has always been of interest to me ever since the cancellation of the WB11 TV series of the same name. The inclusion of Harley Quinn is bound to change the dynamic of the grouping. She, to my limited knowledge, is one of the Birds of Prey, so it should be, hopefully, interesting to watch Harley mess with things. And I do believe this also does take some liberties with a French classic with Audrey Tautou, and it's titled Amelie. Yes, Amelie. I'm sorry, I'm not certain I'm pronouncing it well. So if it's anything like that, which I thought was a brilliant movie, so Birds of Prey hopefully will be able to emulate the success from Amelie. Number 5. Wonder Woman. Despite my not so enthusiastic review of the original movie, I thought it was an okay movie, not the best comic book movie I've ever seen. But then again, that's just me, as I've said earlier. Despite that, I'm truly hoping this entry into the Amazonian legacy will wow me, especially since it takes place in the 80s, where everything is bigger and louder, and shoulder pads defies gravity, and catchphrases like "it's outrageous" were a thing. This is the second go, so hopefully there's limited studio interference. Number 4. Dune. Frank Herbert's Dune is getting another go at the silver screen once again. Hopefully it would go through production pains as the original version, featuring Kyle MacLachlan as Paul Muad'Dib. He is also hoping that this version will surpass the brilliant sci-fi adaptation of the book, which was absolutely amazing, and I'm hoping they would do a fantastic job with this. Number 3. No Time to Die, James Bond. This is probably the final entry for Daniel Craig's portrayal as the titular super spy, James Bond. Haven't missed a single entry in the series and can't wait to see what this troubled production of No Time to Die has in store for us. Daniel Craig is supposed to go out in a bang, and hopefully that's going to be the case with this iteration of the Bond franchise. Number 2. Ghostbusters Afterlife. This Paul Rudd-led feature actually continues the Ghostbuster franchise from the previous ones, the part 1 and 2, featuring the all-time greats, Bill Murray and the rest, and hopefully with this version, it's actually good. It does have a Stranger Field kind of vibe going on over here, and so it should be interesting. It's like taking place in Middle America, so it's got the whole spooky elements going on, and as I said, it's a continuation of the previous story in the movies, so it should be interesting to see where they actually go with this. Alright. And finally, number 1. Tenet. The first Christopher Nolan movie that I am truly looking forward to since the disappointment, that's my own opinion, of the movie that was Interstellar. The trailer whetted my appetite for this sci-fi juggernaut that seems to play with time, just like Inception, but with a twist. Watch the trailer and you'll see what I'm talking about. That so far, folks, is my top 10 upcoming movies of 2020. Like I did say earlier, I will be releasing more in this series. I do believe I have TV series of 2020 and other genres and stuff, whatever. You'll see, just subscribe, and sooner or later, you're gonna get bombarded with my awesomeness. This is your boy, Jack. Take care, and I'll catch you all on the flip side.